Now we are going to study our interruption method. When we are talking about the arc interruption method, let us assume we have one circuit breaker and the arc has been produced in circuit breaker like this. So when we want to interrupt this arc or we want to quench this arc, so we will give any medium, any dielectric medium like air, like sulfur, SF6 basically, and your oil gas, oil. So we will put this and we will quench the arc, but we need to be very specific how interruption of arc will take place. So when we are studying arc interruption method, we have two types of arc interruption method. The first one is high resistance method. The first one is high resistance method basically. So first one is high resistance method. And the second method is natural current zero interruption. Natural current zero interruption. Natural current zero interruption. So what happened in high resistance method is there are two types of high resistance method. The first one is arc splitting. The first one is arc splitting and the second one is by lengthening the gap. So lengthening the gap means arc splitting and by lengthening the gap. Arc splitting means, let us assume we have one circuit breaker here. So we want to quench this arc. So what happened when we just split this? So the arc will concentrate on this. So the area of arc will reduce. So that we know that the resistance R is equal to rho L upon A. The area of arc is reduced. So the arc resistance will increase. Once arc resistance will increase, so it will have the probability of arc interruption more. So this is the first method. Now second one is arc lengthening. Let us assume we are opening the circuit breaker like this length. What we do, we can increase this by like this length. So we know that R is equal to rho L upon A. So L value has increased, so R value has increased. So this is the high resistance method. Now we are moving, that is our in syllabus, natural current zero method. So we are dealing with AC. Natural current zero means current is going 100 times within 1 second. So here it will have the zero crossing. So with the help of zero crossing detector, we will find out the zero crossing, and then we will quench at this exactly point when current will be the weak.